One of my greatest pleasures in life is seeing somebody match with the right productivity app. And one of those apps is the Todoist app. It helps you to manage your tasks, better prioritize, and help you to get more done every single day. So today I wanted to bring together the most excellent 14 Todoist apps on the market to help you get things done. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Akiflow, and here are three standout features to boost your productivity. The first of those is a unified inbox, a great way to bring tasks and events, not just from Akiflow, but from other apps into one location. The second is time blocking, allowing you to schedule your tasks on your calendar so that you can visually see them. And finally, a brand new AI assistant called Aki, which is gonna help you to plan your day more effectively using those technologies. Now, Akiflow is most popular for busy professionals and founders, and you can find it linked below. Sponsors like this help us bring videos to life as well as supporting Tool Finder. But as always, our recommendations are based on genuine editorial opinion, so you can find our full list below. These apps are not ranked in order, but they are all designed for a range of different use cases. So the first app on our list is Todoist. It's the one that I use on a daily basis, and it is a powerful tool for helping you to manage your calendar and your tasks in one location. A lot of people find Todoist as the all-round application, and it's priced fairly reasonably for that too. It's also on a wide range of devices, which is one of the reasons many people like it. It's sort of a good balance between being a complicated app because you could use it for something like GTD, all the way to being a really easy app that somebody like your mother-in-law could use easily every single day to manage projects at home or whatever it may be. So Todoist, what I would say, is probably one of the best all-round to-do list apps on the market, and normally fits about 80% of use cases. So app number two is TickTick. Now, I really think TickTick and Todoist are very similar. They're great all-round experiences, with TickTick coming in slightly cheaper per month. But the application is a really easy one to use. And in my opinion, it has some better calendar abilities than the likes of Todoist. Now, TickTick also presents itself as a habit tracking app and has some smaller features in the premium, like an Eisenhower matrix that can help you to organize the priority of your tasks, which is a cool feature. And it seems to constantly get more additions every single month, which is great, even faster development pace than apps like Todoist in the list. Number three on our list is Akiflow, and it is much more designed for busy professionals, maybe something for those who are much busier than the average person, who are in a management role or something like this. And it has a good feature in it called task consolidation, which allows you to bring in tasks from other applications that allows you to consolidate them in one location. Think of it like a dashboard for your tasks, and then you can plot them in your calendar for those who love time blocking. So for those who are more budget conscious and looking at apps like Todoist and TickTick, this is a lot more expensive, about 3 to 4 times more expensive, but is designed much more to consolidate experiences in one and has more powerful features than those two apps we mentioned above. But obviously the price will reflect that. So number four is Sunsama, and following that price trend, this is another expensive application. The app is designed to be a combination of what Akiflow is, consolidating and bringing in your tasks in one location, a dashboard per se, but also a mindful approach to your productivity. This is incredibly popular for those who have ADHD, busy professionals that want to be able to slow down and have more work-life balance. And one of those features is the minimal nature of it. There's a feature called guided planning, which will help you to organize your tasks for the next day, but also make sure you're not overloading yourself, which is something that a lot of people do. Now, this is much more premium as an application, and much like our next app, it will also be something that tries to combat stuff for busy professionals. Number five is Motion. Many people have heard us talking about Motion here on the channel, and that's because it's a very interesting combination of features. The app is a to-do list app with a focus on AI, helping you to organize your tasks based on an algorithm. So for example, you add all your task input and it suggests best when to do the task, which is something that many of the apps on this list don't do. The application is really easy to use, and also has two other features that may be notable if you're a busy professional and want to share it with other people. Those are project management, allowing you to organize projects with others, and also booking links, allowing you to share booking links, which also Sunsama and Akiflow also do. But this one, again, much more for busy professionals, smaller teams even, and one that is much higher in pricing compared to the first two options. So moving on, our next one, number six, is Superlist. Now this one is a very attractive application, and it comes from the brainchild of Wunderlist, and naturally has expanded in the last year. The application has a slight twist on it compared to other applications in the fact that you can add your projects and notes and your tasks in one location. So this is great for collaborating on meeting notes, agendas, and also just being able to bring checklist-based stuff into the play and coordinate and assign them to other people. Now, there are some light consolidation abilities in here, and the app has grown rapidly since its launch around a year and a half ago, but it is a definite contender for a good all-round to-do list app, and it's in that mid-tier pricing compared to apps like Todoist all the way over to Motion. Now, number seven is Things 3, and while Things 3 has been out for a fair while now, I think it was launched in 2017, it is still on our list for the best to-do list apps. It is a really good application, and it comes as a one-off pricing, which a lot of people like, if you don't want a recurring cost of subscription. Now, the reason I recommend this app is, whilst it doesn't have any sharing abilities, it is a beautiful experience for those who are on iOS and Mac. It allows you to manage your tasks, but most importantly, there's a feature for project scenarios, which I think is personally great for those who are managing projects and want to see an end goal, a goal to complete that as they work towards a project. And I really like how it's designed. It's really easy to use. And if you're using those type of apps, it is smooth like butter, one of the best minimal and attractive applications on the market. So number eight, it's Microsoft To Do. Now this one is not going to be the most attractive app you've ever looked at, but it is going to be a free, easy to use one that integrates with Microsoft products. It will integrate with Outlook, allowing you to flag emails as tasks and also allows you to share lists with other people. Now this one is written off a lot as basic and simple, but it's great as a free experience for getting things done and does more than apps like Google Tasks does as a whole. Number nine is Structured. Now this one is really good value, in my opinion. If you're looking for a much more casual to-do list application, maybe you're organizing your home or you're planning a meetup with friends or whatever it may be, maybe even just a routine for the day. What this does really nice is allow you to create a timeline of your day, but really easily. And there's even an AI feature in the premium, which allows you to dictate what your day wants to look like swimming at 8 a.m., badminton at 10 p.m., whatever it may be. And it will basically plan your day for you, allowing you to tick things off and you can see a progression through the day. So as I said, much more casual, probably not best for work. I'd look at other apps that are higher up in this list or the ones we mentioned before for work, but this one, a great casual use, and they also have a really good premium offer with lifetime value. So number 10 is Trello. Now, Trello is a really beautiful application and it's great for visual people. So if you're somebody that likes lists and organizing their list and being able to drag cards over and custom fields, then this one will be nice for you. You can also add backgrounds and really customize it to your liking. The premium isn't too much. And if you did span this out into working with a team or working with somebody else or sharing with a partner, then it's a good one for you. My sister uses this one, if that's any of reference, and she loves how visual it is in terms of organizing her list for the day ahead, as well as checklists. So number 11 is Routine. And Routine is a really attractive one. If you're looking for that combination of notes, tasks, and calendar, then this could be an interesting option for you. Routine's actually very, very attractive to look at and works very well for Mac. And I believe it is on a few other devices as well. We'll have it here anyway. But Routine is one to look at if you want to be able to take quick notes and to be able to bring those into your experience very fast. The minimal nature of it is great for planning a day, but the calendar is really, really powerful, maybe even too powerful, because it's quite complicated in a sense, because you can actually plan for a day and hold stuff, but really good if you're a calendar-centric person that wants to take notes as well on the side. Next up, number 12 is Lunatask, and I find this one to be a really fast, easy one to use. But the special power in this app is that it is end-to-end encrypted for your notes and your tasks, which if somebody's worried more about how their tasks are stored, then this has end-to-end encryption. not as popular in the task management space, but something that if you're security focused, you might like. The application's mid-tier pricing, slightly more than Todoist, but around or slightly less than apps like Superlist. But it does come with notes. It has a relationship manager in it where you can manage when you last communicated with the person, which is pretty cool. And I love how you can manage stuff like projects and even a journal in there too. Number 13 is Godspeed. Now this one came onto my desk about 6 months ago. And initially I thought, okay, it's just a fast to-do list app. But actually I was very impressed with it because what it does is allows you to use your keyboard much more. So if you're somebody that likes apps like Superhuman, Raycast, I'm thinking of other keyboard-based ones, but let me know in comments if I missed out some. The ones that use your keyboard, this one is fast because you can use your keyboard to just organize stuff. And once you're a week in, you'll probably be blasting through your tasks and adding them, and capture sometimes is incredibly important. Now it's available on a limited amount of devices, but people tend to like it for that. And finally, number 14, I always reference this as the best to-do list app for GTD lovers, and it still is. Nirvana is a beautiful GTD focused application. If you're somebody that's learned GTD in the last year, getting things done by David Allen, you will find this experience to be probably the best all-round experience for that. And I'd highly recommend checking it out if you're somebody that's interested in getting things done. So that was our list today. If you're interested in any of them, you can find them linked below. Per normal, you can continue your research on toolfinder.co. A big, big thank you to Akiflow for sponsoring today's video. So as I mentioned at the start, we curate the list and then we reach out to sponsors to see whether they're interested. And Akiflow jumped on the opportunity to get an initial ad spot at the start of this video, but we keep all of the stuff afterwards as an editorial thing. That's really important to us because as somebody that recommends applications, I want you to find the best app, and that is the most important thing to me. So I hope this list helped you. And if you did enjoy it, feel free to comment below, like the video so that other people can find it, and feel free to share it with a friend if they're looking for a Todoist app, because it will narrow down their search. But as always, you can use Toolfinder as a research tool to find more tools and explore more options. So thank you so much. I look forward to seeing you in a future video, and have a great day ahead. Cheerio for now.